Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Pharmajust GPAT Academy. In the present video, we'll be discussing some MCQs from the subject pharmaceutics, and the topic is Introduction to Dosage Form Design. So the MCQs are taken from the chapter Introduction to Dosage Form Design from the GPAT syllabus. So this video will be helpful for all the pharmacy students who are preparing for NIPER entrance examination, PGESET as well as GPAT examination. So let's begin our video. So the first question is, DASH is a culmination of the efforts of the formulation and production development team. So the options are A, solution, B, dosage form, C, suspension, and D, none of the above. So what is the right answer? The answer is dosage form. So what is a dosage form? Dosage form is a culmination. So it is an output of the efforts of the formulation team and the production development team. Okay. So now coming to the next question. One of the following is a desirable property of a dosage form. So what are the properties of dosage forms? So the options are A, convenient to handle, use and store, B, should be stable during storage, and C, should provide the desired therapeutic effect, and D, all of the above. So what is the right answer? So what is the desirable property of a dosage form? The answer is D, all of the above. That means a dosage form should have all these three properties. It should be convenient to handle, use and store, it should be stable during its storage period, it should provide the desired therapeutic effect. The next question is, the route of administration for lozenges is, the options are A, sublingual, B, intraocular, C, oral, and D, transdermal. So what is the right answer? The right answer is oral. So lozenges are meant for oral route of administration. The next question is, the disadvantage with solid dosage forms is, the options are A, difficulty in swallowing, B, lag time in onset of action, C, degradation due to temperature, and D, both A and B. So what is the right answer? So what is the disadvantage that is associated with solid dosage form? The right answer is D, both A and B. That is difficulty in swallowing and the onset of action is also slow. The next question is, DASH are commonly prepared for antacid and moisture sensitive antibiotics. So the options are A, elixirs, B, effervescent granules, C, powders, and D, tablets. So what is the right answer? So effervescent granules. So effervescent granules, they are prepared for antacid and moisture sensitive antibiotics. The next question is, liposomes are artificial microscopic bilayer vesicles or sacs made of DASH and enclosing an aqueous compartment. The options are A, phospholipids, B, cell membranes, C, gelatin, and D, sphingolipids. So what is the right answer? So what are liposomes? Liposomes are, the options is phospholipids. So liposomes are nothing but artificial microscopic bilayer vesicles or sacs which are made of phospholipids. The next question is, DASH resembles cell membranes in structure and composition. The options are A, G proteins, B, liposomes, C, sphingolipids, and D, microspheres. So this is also a dosage form which resembles cell membranes. So what is the answer? So which is the dosage form that resembles cell membranes? The answer is liposomes. Next, DASH are small solid particulate carriers containing dispersed drug particles either in solution or crystalline form. Crystalline form. The options are A, liposomes, B, nanoparticles, C, microspheres, and D, microcapsules. So what is the right answer? The right answer is microspheres. So microspheres are small solid particulate carriers which contain dispersed drug particles which are either in solution or crystalline form. The next question is, DASH is an example of targeted delivery of drugs to the liver or spleen in the treatment of lysosomal storage diseases and metal toxicity. The options are A. Resealed erythrocytes, B. Nanoparticles, C. Liposomes, and D. None of the above. So, what is the right answer? Resealed erythrocytes. So, resealed erythrocytes, they are targeted drug delivery dosage form, and what do they target? They target either the liver or spleen for the treatment of diseases associated with lysosomal storage diseases and metal toxicity. The next question is, DASH are colloidal particulate systems in the submicron size range acting as carriers of drug molecules. The options are A. Microspheres, B. Nanoparticles, C. Liposomes, and D. None of the above. So, what is the right answer? The right answer is nanoparticles. So, nanoparticles are colloidal particulate systems in submicron size range and they act as carriers of drug molecules. So, that is the end of the video. Thank you for watching the video. Please share, like, and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thank you.